edge technology that's looking at the patient from the inside out. You know, we look at patients and we go, for yourself, we look at you and you go, you're very healthy. No, you're very fit. What do you look like on the inside? I want to see what you look like on the inside. So the lady that came yesterday looked very, very fit. And people would say she's very healthy. We did the scan on the inside. That's not healthy when we see that lesion on her lung. So I guarantee it's going to come back as a pathology. But we're going to save that patient's life because we're going to do early detection. We're the early detectives finding out what's going on the inside. And we're going to be able to save that patient's life or change the course of treatment so that she's going to have a better quality of life if we do find something. And that's with the breast MR technology. You're going to see that with the urograms, with the little kids. We're able to change the way that the healthcare is practiced.
There's imaging, and then there's imaging that really gets to the source. And most of the source doesn't come in axial, coronal, and sagittal answers. So what we have to do is we have to find those oblique angles that allow you to swim around and find that data that you need. We're using MRI, and because our MRI is so sensitive, we're able to image the fetal conjoined twins in the womb. And it's the first time ever, because there are so many factors involved with imaging. You have motion artifact, you have density, material, you know, you're looking at a living thing within a living thing. And you have to get through all that to get clarity. And not only are we imaging these conjoined twins, we're imaging the pathology of which the doctors suspect come along with conjoined twins problems. If they're conjoined the liver, then you want to know what that organ, how much of the organ they share. There's a skull and eye, here are the arms. Here's the bladder of the second child in her head, the spine coming across here, and the shared liver over here. And because of our efficiency, we're able to reach people that don't gain access to this anywhere. So basically, we go out there, we help the people that can't be helped, fall through the cracks, and then we go to the other end of the spectrum. We go to the people that need the help the most but don't have the technology to be able to do it. It's amazing when you go from one end of the spectrum to the other, how many people you touch.
Scan through the whole body and not expose patients to these high doses that are being put out there by the conventional body scans that everybody hears about. We're scanning from the top of the head down through the pelvis area with no radiation at all to the patient.